Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2063, the top or bottom 5 months or years using a pivot table. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jenlow. Today's question sent in by Ken. Ken has an amazing spreadsheet here with years and years and years of daily rainfall dates going back to 1999. Really impressive collection of data that he has. And Ken had some amazing formulas to try and find the month with the most rainfall, least rainfall. I said, oh, you know, this would be a lot easier with a pivot table. All right, now Ken's never created a pivot table, and to further complicate things, I'm here in Excel 2016. Ken's using Excel 2007. My pivot tables that I created in 2016, he could see them, but he couldn't refresh them. All right, so this video is Pivot Table 101, how to create your first pivot table. First, Ken had this data in column A, real dates over here, that's awesome, right? And then I used inserted a couple of extra formulas here, the equal year function to get the year, equal month function to get the month, equal day function, and then concatenate those back together. I actually use the text function in YYYMM. That way I have year and month. Now this is Ken's data, the rain data here, and then I added some formulas. Ken says anything less than 0.5 millimeters doesn't count as a rain day, so there's a formula there. And then from episode 735, go back and take a look at that to see how I calculated the streak of days with rain and streak of days without rain. Now that's not going to be used today, that was used for something else. So we come here, and first we want to select the data for our pivot table. Now in most cases, you could just select all data, so you could just choose one cell here. But in this case, there's a named range that defines the data just through, in this case, 2016. We're sitting here, I'm recording this at the beginning of 2017. Ken's data only goes through the end of 2016. So we're going to select just that data, and then on the Insert tab. Excel 2007 is the first time the pivot table is moved from the Data tab back to the Insert tab. So we choose Pivot Table, and our selected data is going to be the data that we build from. And we don't want to go to a new worksheet, we're going to go to an existing worksheet, and I'm going to put that right over here in column, let's go with column N. Now ultimately, I want this data, years with the lowest rainfall, to appear right here, but I know that as I'm building this pivot table, it's going to need a lot more rows than those five, right? So I'm building it off to the side here, all right, and we click OK. All right, now here's what you get. This is where the report is going to go, and here's a list of all the fields that we have in our little data set. And then we have four, what I call, horribly named drop zones. Rows is the items you want down the left-hand side. Values is the thing that you want to sum up. And then columns are the things you want across the top. We might use this at the end. We're not going to use filters today. So we're just building a simple little pivot table with total rainfall by year. So I take the year field and drag it down here to the left-hand side. There's a list of all of our years. All right, and then think about it, to get this formula here without a pivot table, you'd be doing what, sum if? Oh yeah, sum if. You couldn't even use sum ifs back in Excel 2007. So I'm going to take the rain field and drag that here. All right, now watch out for this. See, they chose count of rain. That's because there's a few days in the data where Ken has a blank cell, an empty cell, instead of a zero. And yeah, we should go through and fix that, but it's Ken's data, it's 20 years worth of data. I'm not going to go through even using find and replace. Right, I'm just going to, for whatever reason, I'm going to respect that Ken has a reason to have those blank. I'm going to allow them to stay blank. And here, under count of rain, I'm going to make sure to choose a cell in the count of rain column, go to field settings, and change that from count to sum. All right, so there is all of our years and how much rain we had in each year. And we're looking for the years with the lowest rainfall. All right, now the one thing that bugs me is this word here, row labels. That started happening to us in Excel 2007, all right? And I, 10 years later, I still despise that. I go to the Design tab, open Report Layout, and say Show in Tabular Form. And all that does, in this particular case, is get a real heading there of year, right? And I prefer the real heading. All right, now we want to see just the top, or in this case, the years with the lowest rainfall. So I'm going to sort this data ascending. Now there's two ways to do this. You could open this drop down, go to more sort options, choose descending based on sum of rain, but it's also possible just to come here and do data A to Z to get things sorted from lowest to highest. But I want to see just the top 5 years. So the years with the lowest rainfall, I come here to the year heading, open this little drop down, and choose value filters, and I'm looking for bottom five. Well, there is no filter for bottom five. Ah, but this one for top 10 is incredibly powerful. All right. It doesn't have to be top, it can be top or bottom. It doesn't have to be 10, it can be 5. So ask for the top 5 items based on summer rain. Click OK. And there is our report. Now, in this case, it would be really highly unusual if we had exactly 2 years with 767.7 inches or millimeters of rain exactly, right? Just not going to happen. But you have to be cognizant of the fact that when you ask for the top five, if there is a tie for that fifth position, you might get a sixth row. If there's a three-way tie, you might get a seventh row. All right, so just be prepared for that. Grand total here really makes no sense since we're showing just the top five, and they're not even five consecutive years. So I'm going to right-click on the word grand total and say remove grand total. Remove grand total. And I'm wondering if that was there in Excel 2007. If it's not there in Excel 2007, go to the Design tab, grand totals off for rows and columns. We'll do the same thing. All right. So now that we have this first pivot table and it's sized correctly, I'm going to copy that pivot table, Control C, make sure to choose the entire pivot table, and go there, years with lowest rainfall. Now, another thing that Ken wants is the years with highest rainfall. All right, so in this case, we're going to sort the data Z to A, descending, and then here, come back into the value filter, go back into top 10, and simply change it from bottom to top, click OK. All right, so once you get the first pivot table built, pivot tables are so flexible, it's incredible how easy it is to just keep changing the pivot table. All right, now here's the gotcha, right? The thing that makes this a little bit difficult. Now we want to look at the years with the least number of rain days, right? How many days did we have the fewest number of days with rain? All right, so now this is going to change the pivot table a little bit because I'm going to take the sum of rain out and I'm going to replace it with rain day. All right. And see, that one automatically came in as sum because my formula here is always returning a numeric value, so we didn't have to change it to a count. And we're looking for the years with the least rain days, so we're going to sort this ascending. All right, so that gets our sort back in. But we've lost the value filter, the top five, because we took the field that it was using, rain, out. So we have to reapply that, value filters, and say top. Actually, we want the bottom. We want the bottom five. Like that. All right, so every time that I take a field in or out over here in the values area, you're going to have to be prepared to redo the sort and redo the filter. So we'll Control C to copy that and paste right here, years with the least rain days. Now, Ken has a lot of other statistics, and I'll leave this up to Ken how to do this, but see here when we change the months with the highest rainfall. All right, so now we're going to be changing a field in the row area. So we take year out, put the month field in like that, and then this goes back to rain instead of rain day, so we put rain in. Now again, they've forgotten that we wanted some, so you have to go back in. In 2007, it's called the Analyze tab. It's the first pivot table tools tab. Go to field settings, choose some like that. Beautiful. And what are we looking for? We're looking for the months with the highest rainfall. So we're going to sort descending, data, Z to A. And then again here, go back into the value filters, top 10, and we will ask for the top 5 like that, right? So very, very flexible. You can figure out the months with the least rain days, the most rain days, and so on. So I'll copy here, Control C, and come down and paste. Now, one other thing that Ken was building, he was building a beautiful master table that took this daily data and summarized it by year and month. So let's just do that. Let's put years down the left-hand side like this. Years down the left-hand side. I got lazy there. I tried to check mark it. It went to the wrong spot. We have sum of rainfall, but we want to see months going across. And I know I have some other data out here to the right, so I'm just going to insert a whole bunch of extra columns. Insert columns, so that way I know that my pivot table won't crash into that. Beautiful thing here, that month field, the 1 through 12, I take that and drag it to the columns. And I now have a report showing years down the side, months going across the top, and the summary of how much rain we had in each one of those pivot tables are just an amazing, amazing feature. All right, if you're new to pivot tables, my new book, Power Excel with Mr. Excel. This book hit the bookstores January 1st, about 36 days ago, but the new ebook versions for the Kindle, for your iPad, or a PDF. Those are all now available at Mr. Excel. If you buy the book from me, if you buy the print book from me, you get all three of those ebook formats for free. Mine have no DRM, no hassles. We believe in no hassles. You buy the book, you get all the formats at once. Click the link down there in the YouTube description to get to my page where you can buy that book. So, wrap up. Pivot tables created in Excel 2013 or 2016 can't be refreshed in 2007. You have to create the pivot table in 2007 to allow it to be refreshable. So, our goal is to find the 5 months with the least rainfall. I created a large pivot table with rainfall by month. I knew that it was going to fit in more than five rows, so I built it off to the side. Sort by rainfall. Actually, ascending is what we did here. Change to tabular form, and then open that drop down in the first column using the value filters top five. It's weird. You ask for the top 10, and you get the bottom five. Took the grand total row out. Even though we're asking for five, you might get six if there's ever a tie, six or seven. And then once we had the first pivot table, copied it into place, and then created the next pivot table, and just kept doing that. Although, a couple of gotchas, when you change from one value field to another, you have to redo the sort and filter. You might have to redo the count to sum. When you change from one row field to another, you have to redo the sort and filter. And then, right there at the end, showed you how to create a pivot table with rows and columns. All right, well, hey, I want to thank Ken for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.